Beth, I've been thinking about this and I've decided.
Lynn! Are you ready? Yes.
Yes, I was.
You know, with the traffic's like at this time of the day. Yeah, I know what you're going to say. If I had made a later appointment, then we could avoid the traffic altogether. But then half the day's gone, hasn't it, eh? Fritted away at the doctor's. Well, I could be doing something more useful. Now, if we set off on time, we can avoid the worst of it.
I am ready. I was just...
I hate being late, especially when it's avoidable, which it usually is. The first thing they learn in my class is the importance of punctuality. Everything else is built on that. I don't want excuses, I tell them. Just don't let it happen again. And it doesn't. A lesson for life. I may forget why Nelson won Trafalgar, but they don't miss appointments.
They're not going to like it.
It's only just 9, Katrina.
I'm not going to like it if I have to rearrange the appointments yet again.
And they won't mind seeing a few extra patients. I wouldn't.
Really?
If there's a valid reason for Jude being late, which there probably is.
So why doesn't she let us know?
Because she's probably on her way.
And if there was a problem, she'd let us know, wouldn't she?
Well, I wouldn't be too sure. She hasn't exactly got a great record for letting people know, has she?
Well, call her then.
I did. Her mobile switched off.
Jude? If you pick up this message, will you call me back, please? Because I don't know where you are, what you're doing. Look, we don't have to panic yet. We don't know if it was Sean's body. We don't know if it was his parents at the mortuary, not for certain. And we have to be sure of those things before we do anything else. All right? So, just call me back, will you?
It's just Mr. Holmes and his back. Everyone else is sorted.
Look, tell him to bring it back tomorrow.
Well, I can't do that, can I? He'll be on his way.
Look, if I see any more patients this morning, they're hardly going to have time to tell me what's wrong. What about Mark? Or is he still busy surfing the net?
He's already got extra. It's not my fault, is it? Anyway, that's a really nice tie you're wearing today, Ben.
Oh, I'll do my best.
Still here. I know it's still here because it was last time. Well, that was 3 years ago. I have perfect recall.
You should report to reception first.
Well. Report to whom, Lynn? There's nobody there.
Oh, that's me. Or it should be, sorry.
Archie Grace to see Dr. Thompson.
Well, we're one quack short of a duck call this morning, I'm afraid.
I mean,
we're short-staffed.
Well, I have an appointment at 10, and it's 10 now. Since there's nobody to greet me, I thought I'd come through.
I'm afraid Dr. Thompson had to fit someone else in first, but she'll be with you as soon as she can.
That's all right. We don't mind waiting.
Oh, it's we, is it? Oh, you speak for me now, do you? No, I can articulate, you know. I have got the vocabulary. I quite understand if there's an emergency, Doctor. It happens quite often at school. One has to learn to cope. Helps if people cooperate, doesn't it? Come on now, then.
Poor woman, it must be like being with a souped-up parrot.
I thought Mr. Holmes, is it?
No.
Look, I'll take Mr. Holmes, but don't say I don't do anything for you.
Oh, bless you, Ben. You are a star.
Oops. Sorry, this dance is already taken.
Yes, well, some of us have work to do, you know.
I just thought that I might be able to see her between appointments.
Well, you could.
I only want a quick word.
Yeah, me too.
She's not in.
Oh. Well, what, shout and call or something?
There's no good asking us.
Only when I got up this morning, she wasn't there. I guess she'd already left.
Not for here, she hasn't.
Katrina, we've tried her mobile, but she can't be reached.
Oh, well, it's probably batteries or something. And the car's conked out. Can I write her a note? Do you mind?
Oh, of course not. Look, leave it with us and we'll make sure she gets it.
Thanks.
I don't know whether it might have occurred to you that Jude could be in some sort of trouble.
What was I saying?
Well, it doesn't help to keep chipping away. You can see how worried Beth is.
Of course, I know what brought this condition on. DIY.
Very probably.
So not tennis. I haven't played tennis since I was in my 20s, which is long ago and far away, I can tell you. But they persist in calling it tennis elbow for some reason.
Well, I suppose that's because tennis...
In my case, it's not the tennis racket which is the culprit, it is the screwdriver. self-assembly bookshelves, made of far harder wood than the instructions will admit to, and requiring almost 30 screws to hold the thing together. And not one of the little beggars wants to go in, Doctor. Well, you can imagine. Oh.
Yes, well, what I can do for you is...
A complete misnomer, of course. Self-assembly gives the impression that it will construct itself before your very eyes, like something out of The Sorcerer's Apprentice, which I can assure you it does not.
No, well, I can give you anti-inflammatory pills, which will help bring down the swelling.
Ah, yes, quite. I know the drill. Oh, now, there's a thought. If I could drill the holes first before taking up the screwdriver...
Mr. Grace, your cough.
I beg your pardon?
You seem to have a cough.
Oh, that? Oh, that's nothing. That's occupational hazard. I teach history, you know.
Yes, she did mention it.
And you can't do that without a certain amount of spouting. I very often get something of a tickle, especially when the Christmas term lengthens. Recently, I've been trying to convey the matrimonial complexities of Henry VIII. And his politics as well. Not a bad king in many ways, though a tyrant on the domestic front, of course.
So that's why he had to drive then, because of his tennis elbow.
Yes.
Oh. He's lucky you were there then, wasn't he? He's a teacher, isn't he?
That's right.
Oh, I bet that keeps him busy.
Any messages?
What? Oh, no. It wasn't Jude. At least I don't think so. They rang off without speaking.
Oh.
Well, thanks for your help.
Okay. Bye then.
Mobile phones, eh? Never out of touch these days, are you?
I suppose not.
Right then, well, suppose I'd better press on. You know, busy morning and all that.
Yes, me too.
Oh, what's that then? Shopping list?
No, it's... Well, I'm sure you wouldn't be interested.
Oh, go on. You know, we're over the worst of it now. What is it?
I'm trying to make a few plans.
I don't want to keep you. I know we've all got extras this morning.
Quite.
I just wanted to say, well, you know, it's just not my style, bearing grudges.
You think that's what I'm doing, do you?
Oh, no, of course not. I was talking about me.
Oh, you?
Yeah. That's what I was trying to say. You said a few things yesterday about my attitude.
They were quite valid, if I remember correctly.
Yes. Well, you had a point. I thought about what you said and... Maybe you're right. Maybe I do need to tighten up a bit.
So, this is an apology, is it?
In a way. But you did come on strong.
Strong? Did I?
Yes, well, you had a point, and it's silly to let things rumble on.
Right. Yes, well, I didn't mean to be quite so forceful. So, right and wrong on both sides, probably. Water under the bridge, eh?
You take a seat, Mrs. Turner.
It's keeping it all a secret that's the difficulty. I want it to be a surprise for Mumsy.
So you're inviting people from all over?
Yes. They've all moved away since Mum worked with them. It's only three or four, but they were very close, and I know she'd like to see them again.
It's a bit like This Is Your Life, isn't it?
In a way.
Is it her birthday, then?
Yes.
Oh. Oh, well, I think it's lovely. I wish somebody'd do something like that for me.
Trouble is, there's more work than I thought, trying to trace them. And I'm on tenterhooks all the time in case it all goes wrong or the secret gets out.
Ah, well, I think we can take that off our list, Lynn. Much as I expected. The bookcase will have to remain semi-constructed for the time being, I'm afraid, which is a nuisance. I've a whole section of books on the Napoleonic Wars. They're just stuck in corners. I hate disorder, don't you?
Oh, yeah, it's like when you're...
At least a shelf on the Navy alone. Fascinating, of course. But you want to be able to put your hand on the book you want, don't you? You don't want to have to crawl on your hands and knees for it. Place for everything. Everything in its place, that's what I always say.
Beth, I got your message. And I did call back, but I didn't want to speak to you, so I rang off.
Amputations were by no means easy in the ship of the line in that period. With the pitching and the rolling, and very often they had gunfire going off all around them as well. Yeah, what happens at the time? Come on, Lynn. We are keeping this young lady from her work.
Oh, no, it was very interesting, Mr. Gray.
Yes, it is, isn't it, Katrina? It is Katrina, isn't it?
It is, yeah. My mum always...
Come on now, we must see about this prescription.
Bye, then, and good luck with the birthday.
Mm-hmm. Birthday? Oh, what birthday?
No. No, after you.
Tell you what, I'll do one for both of us.
Thanks very much. Herbal tea, though.
Of course.
You're getting through your extras, all right?
Oh, well, not bad, thanks. Haven't got any idea where Jude is, have you?
I don't think anyone has. Mm. Mark, I was meaning to ask you about the internet.
Yeah?
Do you think it helps?
Well, of course, why not?
It just seems a bit time-consuming, that's all. You know, round the houses. Especially when you can find it quicker in a book.
You think so?
And that way you get to spend longer with your patients.
I don't shortchange them, if that's what you mean.
No, that's not what I meant.
And it's my time, isn't it? So what I do with it's up to me.
I simply don't understand why. Why you didn't tell me. Well, a celebration of this nature? You know, it's one of my strengths. Organisation, attention to detail.
I just wanted to arrange things myself.
Yeah, well, see, well, it's got you. And you fix it up for next week. Next week of all times. Ah, you left me precious little time to sort this out, Lynn. I suppose you realise that?
But I said I wanted to do it myself.
Oh, I see. By yourself. However much that might cause inconvenience to everybody else. Well, perhaps you better go home by yourself as well, because I think I shall go by bus.
You go and I'll sort that out. I'll be back.
Come on.
Look, you're just trying to pick a fight.
That's rubbish.
Yes, you are. You talk about my attitude, but at least I'm making an effort. Maybe you want to take a good look at your own.
Please. You're sounding like a couple of schoolboys. You know you can be heard out there. What kind of an impression are you hoping to create?
I don't have to stand here.
Well, don't. Haven't you got patients to see?
Yes, I have. Irritable bowel. But it can't be more irritable than that joker, though, can it?
I didn't tell Dad about the plans because he would have taken over.
I'm sure he only wanted to help.
Yes, I know. But it's not just that. I don't want him to come. Not at all.
Well, not come, but it's your mum's birthday.
He'll spoil it and talk all evening. It'll end up not being about Mum at all. So I just wanted her with a few friends because she's had years of this.
Well, maybe if you explain. Tell him it's a girls-only celebration or something.
I don't even think he knows what he's like. He thinks he's the life and soul of the party. That's why I arranged it for the day of parents' evening at school, to make sure he'll be safely out of the way.
And now I've gone and put my foot in it.
No, it's me. I've put his back up. Well, I never meant to do that. I better see if I can catch him up.
Maybe you should let him cool down first.
No, it's all right. Anyway, he'll be expecting me to pick him up at the bus stop.
Bye. It's not just Mrs. Grace that lives in Archer's shadow. That poor girl's got the self-esteem of a dormouse.
I should have kept my big mouth shut. But do you reckon I should try and sort this out?
How?
I don't know. Give him a bell. Because if I fouled things up...
I don't think so, Katrina.
But what if he complains?
No, I've got to pop out later. If I've got time, I'll pop in and see them.
Ben, look, I'm sorry I came to headmistress earlier on today.
You had a point, I suppose.
Well, I think so. I mean, we can't have staff coming to blows now, can we?
Well, I'm sorry too. But I was trying to patch things up with him.
Yes?
But it's no good with him. He's so hypersensitive.
Well, that may as well be. But I think he might have good reason at the moment. His mother's just died and he's feeling a bit tender. I think we should be making allowances for that, don't you?
Beth, I got your message. And I did call you back, but I didn't want to speak to you, so I rang off. Sorry. The thing is, Beth, it's getting to me, all this not knowing. We saw Sean's parents, for goodness sake. We saw them grieving, and the way his mum looked at me. Well, I can't shut that out. This isn't going to go away, Beth. So I've made my mind up. I'm going to the police.
and I'm going to tell them everything.
I've got a call to make at Manor Park, so is this a good time to talk?
It's all right. Dad's gone to the chemist.
I'm sorry about what happened this morning, if it landed you in trouble.
He'll get over it.
Katrina wanted me to see if you're okay.
Well, it's not her fault, but...
So are you okay?
Me?
Because you don't look too bright.
There's nothing wrong with me.
No? Maybe if you told him straight about your celebration.
No, it wouldn't do any good.
Because if he doesn't know he's doing it, I don't think this is doing you any good.
I told you, I'm all right.
And it will go on, won't it? Not just your mum's birthday, but other things. If you just let him know.
I can't, Dr. Thompson. I won't.
I know it won't be easy.
Not easy? It'll be impossible. You don't know him. And even if I tried, I'd never get a word in edgeways.
I don't know, maybe I did raise my voice a bit.
I heard, we all heard.
I didn't mean for it to go like that. Especially, you know, the way things are.
What do you mean with his mum and everything?
Yeah. He isn't easy though, is he?
You don't have to tell me, I know.
I mean, one minute he's moody and then he doesn't talk to anyone.
And the next minute he suddenly explodes, I know.
Is it just his mum, do you think?
Oh, it can't be, can it? I mean, he's been like it from day one. I mean, he's had a right go at me before now, you know. And that was before his mum died.
Maybe it's something else that's getting him down. Do you reckon?
I was looking for my sister.
Yes?
I thought she might have called in here. She said she might.
She might, then. What's her name?
Her name.
Always a useful pointer when we're trying to identify someone.
Yes, of course. Only she might have used a different name. She was in a bit of a state. I mean, she's all right. I just need to see her. Has she been here, do you think?
It's possible, miss. Tell you what, let's start with your name and what this is all about.
Oh, is that necessary?
Well, I'm beginning to think it is, yes.
I only want to see my sister.
Who might have given a false name and you won't tell me yours, so let's start again, shall we? What exactly do you want?
Oh! There she is. Oh! Oh, sorry. I thought... Oh. Yeah, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
No, sorry.
Then perhaps I can make a suggestion. Why don't you try the other station? I'm sure they've got plenty of time on their hands.
Other? But there's only one police station in Leatherbridge, isn't there?
No, Gaynor, listen. You're not listening to me. It's not next week, it's the week after. Same day, same time, same place, but different week. Well, I had to rearrange it because my muddle-headed daughter forgot that I had to be at a parents' evening. Oh, and another thing, Gaynor, there'll be more of us. Yes, I've invited some of the Bowls Club committee. Well, she will know them by the end of the evening, won't she? Yeah, well, I've got to get on now. I've got a whole long list of people who need informing. Yeah, yes, yeah, it's right. Yeah, goodbye. Oh, I suppose you realise how much work you left me with, Lynn. Yes, I know. It's supposed to be a surprise, but it still needs to be planned, you know? It still needs organisation.
Are you all right?
Yeah, perfectly all right. I hadn't spent the last 2 hours on the phone. It's a lot better. Yeah, there you are. They just burn your ear off, you know, some of your mother's cronies, how they talk. Now, I've made a few notes for a little speech.
Oh, do you think we need a speech?
Oh, we can't not have speeches, Lynn, can we? Well, an occasion like this needs marking, doesn't it? Ah, don't get up. Now, just sit there and listen to me. May be able to tell me where it needs expanding. Now, I well remember 32 years ago, the day Margaret first met me.
Come.
You're seeing Mrs. Padgett?
Yes, I will be.
Well, she'll be a couple of minutes. She's in the loos.
Right, thanks.
Okay.
Right, Hess. Hello, Mrs. Paget. What can I do for you?
Oh, is everything all right?
Well, I know it's short notice, but we were wondering if Dr. Thompson had a moment.
Well, I'm afraid she's not back yet.
Or anyone else. Only a bit of an emergency has cropped up.
Well, I'll see what I can do, but we're still short-handed. Mr. Grace, back already?
We don't want to be a bother, but if you've got any time at all, it'd be really...
That's okay. I'm back early. Why don't you come through?
Kate, have a look at this. Wait a minute. My internet search has come up with an address. Well, email contact.
Oh, Mark, that's wonderful.
Of course, I can't be sure that it's her, but it's a distinct possibility.
Well, have you tried it yet?
No, been too busy. Anyway.
What?
Well, I don't know. It feels strange, Kate. I mean, this could be my mother. But, you know, my birth mother. Total stranger.
Of course, but...
I mean, I know I didn't get on well with Mum, but she was the one that brought me up, and isn't this like turning my back on her?
No, no, it's not, Mark. What this is untangling your past. And Pat would have wanted that for you, wouldn't she?
Perhaps. I mean, if I do go ahead with this, there's no knowing what I'm going to uncover, is there?
No, but...
I mean, it may sort out a lot of things for me, like, you know, to do with where I'm from and everything. But suppose it doesn't. Suppose it just makes things worse.
It's a fairly chronic inflammation of the larynx. Quite painful, I should imagine. I'd rest your voice if I were you, Mr. Grace.
He hasn't had a cold or anything.
Well, there are many possible causes. Overuse of the voice in this case, probably. Of course, it's an occupational hazard with jobs like teaching. You said so yourself. In fact, some people call it clergyman's throat.
Oh, dear. Can you give him anything for it?
Inhaling over a bowl of steam might help, but the best thing I can prescribe is this. It's so you can write down anything you might want to say. It's not a dangerous condition, but you really should rest your voice. So, I'm afraid you're going to have to do the talking for your father from now on. For the time being, at least.
Excuse me, I need to talk to someone.
What about?
Well, it's a bit hard to explain.
Excuse me, we've got an emergency on our hands here. I wish to deposit my friend's key card in a safe place.
Just a minute, sir.
I haven't got a minute, officer. If the arm of the law doesn't act, this plonker intends to drive his car.
I'm sorry, madam. Might be best if we see to these gentlemen first.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's an emergency, you see.
Right. That's it, Kate. I've done it. So, what will be, I suppose.
Rearrange it again? Why? No, Dad, it's all right. I know what you mean. You won't be able to make your speech if you're still like this, will you? The trouble is... I have already rearranged it. Back to where it was before. Which means you definitely won't be able to make it. But that's all right, really, Dad. Because you weren't invited. It was just for Mum for a change. No, Dad, you must look after that voice. You don't want to lose it for good, do you? Actually, I did think that might be rather nice. But it wouldn't really be you, would it? No, this is best. A brief silence so I can have my say. You see, you do go on a bit, Dad. On and on, in fact. And it does get, well, boring. But I could never tell you that before because I knew you'd go up the wall and then I'd never be able to tell you the rest. I'd never get the chance.
Because we do love you, Dad. In spite of all that gassing. So this party is just for Mum. It's going to be without you. But when it's over, we'll come back and tell you all about it. And you can sit and listen. And that'll be lovely for all of us.
I told you I'm doing this. It's got nothing to do with you.
Don't be so stupid. Of course it has. The police would get to me in the end, wouldn't they? You can't just do this on your own.
But I have to do something. You saw his parents outside the mortuary, didn't you? You saw the suffering in their faces.
I saw two people who'd lost their son with a pile of clothes and things that might or might not have been Sean's.
Yes, and one of those things might link him to us. So doesn't that change everything? We can't just let it go.
Yes, we can. Now, we've been through this. We have to know for certain there's a link and we don't, do we? Do we?
I don't know. I don't know.
Yes, you do. You'd risk everything and you don't even know if it's him. Now, come on. We're getting out of here before you do something both of us regret.